ain't playing with you. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's been a long time that I haven't filmed. Honestly, it's been like a week or so, but it has felt like so long. I've been under the weather, so in this video I'm gonna sound a little weird. My voice is not the best right now, but I am under the weather, so bear with me guys. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to get this look with the Norvina Anastasia palette. If you are interested in seeing how I did this, definitely keep on watching. Alright guys, so today's video is going to be solely focused on the Norvina ABH Volume 3 palette. When you pull it out of the box, this is what it looks like. It's just like this, and then the back is black. And then it has a beautiful mirror. Look at the mirror. That's truly all you need. Is this big mirror. And then it opens like a lot. It opens a lot, so that's awesome. It comes with a protective film over the eyeshadows, as all eyeshadow palettes should, because that just helps protect the eyeshadows from getting damaged. Definitely don't want that to happen. So you have a wide range of colors. So honestly, this eyeshadow palette really has anything. It has all the colorful shadows that you need. It has all of the fall-like eyeshadows you need. A lot of holidays are coming up, and the shimmers in this palette are gorgeous. So I did my eyebrows off camera just because they take the longest in my eyes. So this is what I used. I used the Anastasia Brow Powder in dark brown, and I used the 7B brow brush that they sell on their website and at Sephora. And I used the same ABH brow gel in the color clear. So that's my eyebrows, and then I carved them out with the CoverGirl True Blend Undercover Concealer. This concealer is amazing, and I went ahead and I primed my lids with that as well and set them in place with Maybelline Fit Me Powder in Fair Light. This is the translucent powder. Amazing. I'm gonna go in with E2, which is like a dark plummy brown. This is like an off-brand brush. I got it at Walgreens, so it doesn't have a name, but any brush that has the tip like this, that's kind of pointy, will work. So I'm gonna go ahead and pack that on the outer corner of my eye. I'm not gonna worry about blending it out just yet. This shade is gorgeous. It's, like I said, a plum shade, and I am living for it. Look how that's pigmented as can be. So I used E2 first, and now I'm going to go in with A2, which is this shade right here, same row, just the orange shade. And I'm going to place that above this plum shade. And I'm not going to worry about blending it. Like I said, I'm just going to go and place it to the pigmentation that I want. And once I get it to how I want it to look, I'm going to go ahead and worry about blending it out. So that's what that looks like. I think that's as orange as I want it for right now. I'm gonna go in and go with that yellow shade, E2, which would be this one right here. And I'm just gonna go ahead and place that yellow. Look how pigmented that is. I'm gonna place the yellow on top of the orange. And what I'm noticing with these shades is that they're super easy to blend. Like, you don't really have to work with them. They work with you. Now I'm gonna worry about blending. So I'm gonna go in with that first shade and just blend it into the orange, and then do the same with the orange into the yellow, and I'll be right back. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to carve out that front portion of my eye. Alright, so I kind of gradiently tried to blend those colors together. Now, right after the concealer, I'm not going to set the concealer. I'm actually going to go in with Trust Issues from the Jackie Aina palette, which is this color right here. It's like a really shimmery white shade. And I'm going to take that color with just a flat shader brush and pack it on. I'm just going to drag it all the way up to meet the orange and yellow eyeshadow, just because I feel like if I stop at the crease, it'll look a little weird. So I'm just going to drag it up. And then I'm just going to try to blend these colors together so they don't look harsh. I'm just going to take a short bristled brush like this, take C1 and put it on the brow bone. Just to make it pop, since the eyeshadow did go a little high in this look. Alright, so we're almost practically done with the look. I'm going to go ahead and do my lips on camera for you guys. I'm going to keep it pretty neutral. I'm going to go ahead and use the CoverGirl Caramel Nude Lip Liner and just line my lips. And then I'm going to go ahead and use the Milani Teddy Bear Lipstick. And that's it, guys. That's how you get this look that I did today. All right, so that's the end of this video. Thank you guys for watching today's video. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. Leave me down below any video ideas you guys want to watch, because at the end of the day, I do film for you guys. Bye.